They're dead. They're dead. As far as I'm concerned, they're dead. They thought that they had to kill people in order to put themselves in a little better negotiating position. When they did that, they killed 12 people. One happened to be a great American soldier, a wonderful young man from Puerto Rico, families from Puerto Rico. And you can't do that. You can't do that with me. So they're dead as far as I'm concerned. And we've hit the Taliban harder in the last 4 days than they've been hit in over 10 years. So that's the way it is. In terms of advisors, I took my own advice. I like the idea of meeting. I've met with a lot of bad people and a lot of good people during the course of the last almost 3 years. And I think meeting is a great thing. I think that meeting with, you know, you're talking about war. There are meetings with war. Otherwise, wars would never end. You'd have them go on forever. We had a meeting scheduled. It was my idea, and it was my idea to terminate it. I didn't discuss it with anybody else. When I heard, very simply, that they killed one of our soldiers and 12 other innocent people, I said, there's no way I'm meeting on that basis. There's no way I'm meeting.
Can you just explain why this matters? I mean, it's one thing to say your crowd sizes at inauguration are bigger than they are. Why is this so concerning to you?
This matters because the president's changing of that weather map really crossed a line in terms of the sanctity of the weather forecast. It's important that the National Weather Service speak with one voice in unison because they communicate to all the weather forecasters out there in the country about what's the real forecast, what's the most up-to-date information. And it has to be up-to-date because the storms can change, as we've seen.
And when you saw that statement from NOAA that was put out to back up what the president had said, it wasn't signed. And that's significant.
It was significant because the agency really wasn't willing to stand behind it. And the leaders wouldn't say no, that they wouldn't put it out. And it clearly had a chilling effect on the agency. And it made those weather forecasters think twice about whether or not to put out the most up-to-date information if it was going to look like it contradicted the president. What they did was completely routine. What they did was exactly what we would have expected them to do when I was at NOAA, which is to get the most up-to-date information out to the public as quickly as possible.
Richard, I mean, to say this out loud sounds ludicrous, but as you pointed out, I mean, we have federal employees getting reprimanded for accurately disclosing scientific truth.
We do. And this is yet one more instance of the Trump administration distorting facts in order to cover for the president politically, presenting alternative facts in Kellyanne Conway's language. And now it's affecting the weather. It's affected our national intelligence reports. It's affected our approach to climate change and other scientific evidence about environmental degradation from sulfide mining and all sorts of things. And now we even have politicized weather reports.